Frame.io is a really great collaboration tool that I use with my clients to allow them to comment on videos as we're going back and forth through the editing process. And it allows us to have a little conversation and me to check off things as they're completed. In this video, what I'm going to do is show you how you can leave those comments in Frame.io. So you're going to get a link that will open in frame.io, and you'll see, perhaps you'll see multiple files, or you'll see just one file here. And I'm just going to double click on this to show you kind of the interface. We can see here the video. You can play it up here.
If you're from the United States and you're...
And also you can, you know, just like a regular video player, you can move ahead, move back, stuff like that. Everything is pretty self-explanatory there. Change the speed, whatnot. Now, what's different is you'll see this over here on the right is a column where your comments will show up, and also my comments would show up if you're one of my clients, or the entire conversation about the video happens over here. So let's go through and add a comment. So say we want to comment at 8 seconds in that we want to remove this guest. You can just play along, and when you start typing your comment, it'll pause. So let's do a remove guest image here. You could also comment, you know, put text on the screen, whatever it is you want to do. You could actually even draw on the screen. So say we want to use this, we're going to just cross this out, or, you know, whatever it is you want to do. You want to say, okay, this over here is distracting, you know, this point right there. So lots of options for drawing and for typing. And actually, if you haven't already set this up, it's going to ask you what your email address is, so that it can keep track of who is doing this, and it'll send you emails when things are complete. It might ask you to confirm that, but I've already used this email address. So as you can see, that shows up here, and you can get a reply from someone, you can reply back to them, you can edit the comment. So there's a lot of things you can do over here on this side. So let's also look at a couple things here in terms of versions. So as you're going through this process, you might be getting a new version update, and you'll look here and you'll only see one video, but there's multiple versions. For this one, it says there's two versions, version two. So let's, or actually that version two, that was the thumbnail there. And you can see up here, I can switch back and forth between version one and version two. So you can compare the versions too, so that it plays along. You can actually see exactly in the different versions what is showing up on screen at any one point in time in those different versions. And you can, I believe here, choose which one of them you want the audio coming from, just in case the audio is any different. You can click here and say, okay, well, we're listening to the audio from version two, or we're listening to the audio from version one. And once again, make those changes there so that you can see if there was something you asked to be changed at the first version and you were like, wait a minute, what did I ask before? You can go back, read those comments, and see the difference in the film. So let's go back. The only other thing here is to be able to, you can change this, you know, needs review in progress status. This is just depends on who you're working with. I like to, you know, mark things as needs review or in progress until it is ready to go. So if you have any questions about this, feel free to leave them down in the comments below. But if you are one of my clients, reach out directly and we'll get you up and running on Frame. Thanks so much for watching.